With success in life comes more haters. Don't make them hurt your feelings. Use them for fuel. Use them for energy. In times of need, put them on the fucking mental Rolodex in your mind. And when you don't want to do shit, roll through your brain. Pull up that motherfucker that you need. That person who said you couldn't do something. Weren't fast enough, good enough, smart enough, where the fuck you may be. Use them for energy. Instead of killing them with kindness, torture them with fucking success. In life, we have to continue pushing past the odds. Use everything this world has to give you for fuel. Stay hard.
Take 10 seconds to get it again, beast. Get it, David. Come on. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Energy. Let it out. 7, 8, 9, 10. A machine here. There you go. Nobody works like David in this house. 13. Come on. 14. Come on. 15. Shut that muscle down. 16. Come on. Get it. 17.
You don't know me, son.
Get it. 18.
You don't know me, son.
Get it. 19.
You don't know me, son.
Yeah. 20, you got some more in you. 21, yeah, get it again. Come on, we want to see it. Good, 22.
Who's going to carry the boats and the logs?
That's you, buddy. Come on, 23. Come on, 24. One more, David.
Who's
one more?
Going to carry the boats?
You're going to do it. You're going to do it. You're going to do it. You did it. Yeah.
Be unapologetic, get after it, stay hard, be who the fuck you are. That's what taking souls is about. Don't worry about the elements and what's going on. You gotta get out there and get it. That's taking souls, and obviously, he wasn't the only one that thought about taking the day off. Because the storm's coming in right now. There's not a soul out here with me. Life. This applies to everything in life. Anytime you move from being normal to trying to be exceptional, people aren't gonna like that shit. Those normal people, it makes them feel like shit, so they're gonna judge you. And nowadays, it's very easy to be a fucking coward. Why? We got Instagram and shit. Most folks don't tell you to your face. They go online, they post about like cowards. Don't let cowards get in your fucking head. And last thing, make sure you do you. Stay hard.
Military, we call these instructor-led runs. Most of the time, we knew the start and end point. So on the way back, I start seeing people getting happy and shit because the end was near. But there were some asshole instructors that would hear the happiness and go right on past the end point. When that happened, everybody stopped talking. Heads would stop dropping. And I started taking fucking souls. At that time, I knew what happened in their minds. They were living off the hope factor. They hoped the instructors would stop running. They hoped the water was never cold. They hoped the weather was fucking good. I don't live off that hope shit. I wish the water was cold. I wish them motherfucking instructors keep on fucking running. I wish for fucking rain. When the ending is unknown and the distance is unknown, that's when you know who the fuck you are.
You do what you have to do, say what you have to say, and live the life you have to live. Don't walk around being a fake human being. Don't be scared to be who you are. Stay hard. And I'm sitting there thinking, take a day off. No one will know. But I keep on thinking too. There's always someone out there working harder than you. I'm haunted by that motherfucker. Know that that's someone out there. It's willing to forgo personal desires and comforts, forgo sleep, forgo whatever it takes to be better, to be the best. In life, a lot of times, we'll always have that person out there. It may not be a name or a face to him, but he exists. You make sure in life, when they think about that person, you make sure they put a name and face to it. You make sure that name and face is yours. You keep it haunted. Get in somebody's head. Own space. In those times when you want to quit, because we're all human, you make sure you remember one thing. All those times and hours and days
You sacrificed to be the best. Stay hard.